In bankruptcy, every time you turn over a rock, you find yet another circuit split. And we have a humdinger as a result of an August 30th opinion from the Ninth Circuit in a case called Hunsaker versus U.S. The case dealt with sovereign immunity, which is always difficult and even more complex in the bankruptcy arena. Historically speaking, back in 1992, the Supreme Court held that Section 106 and its waiver of sovereign immunity, as it read at the time, failed altogether to waive sovereign immunity because Section 106, as it read at that time, was not sufficiently explicit. Thank goodness Congress turned around 2 years later and adopted the current version of Section 106, which for most purposes these days is a sufficient waiver of sovereign immunity. However, it's not always clear exactly how extensive that waiver is. For instance, in 2005, the First Circuit handed down a case called Rivera, in which that appeals court in Boston ruled that there was no waiver of sovereign immunity with respect to a claim against the federal government for emotional distress damages resulting from a willful violation of the automatic stay. The Hunsaker case, however, which came down, as I said, on August the 30th, is a flat-footed disagreement circuit split with the First Circuit, because the Ninth Circuit held explicitly that there is a waiver of sovereign immunity and a debtor injured by the government's willful violation of the automatic stay can obtain damages for emotional distress. This, I think, is a modestly attractive case for the U.S. Supreme Court. We will find out, I guess, in the next 3 months or so whether it's going to go up. But to read more about this opinion, read my column, Rochelle's Daily Wire, on the ABI website. Until same time next week, this is Bill Rochelle, ABI's editor-at-large, saying good day.